crashing, hit a wall. Right now I need a miracle. Hurry up now, I need a miracle. Stranded, reaching out. I call your name, but you're not around. I say your name, but you're not around. I need ya, I need ya, I need you right now. Yeah, I need you right now. So don't let me, don't let me, don't let me down.
There is only one good, the cause and the support of a happy life. Alrighty, good morning. So today I'm going to be talking about The Practicing Stoic by Farnsworth. This book is a broad overview of the teachings from the Stoic traditions, the purpose of Stoicism being the service and the help of all mankind. The four main virtues of Stoicism: wisdom, justice, courage, and moderation. And it is in the pursuit of these virtues that we find the product of happiness and that we can live up to our highest potential as human beings. So number one, wisdom. Wisdom is the product of a sound mind, the ability to seek out and find competent individuals to consistently and constantly educate oneself throughout an entire lifetime to move towards the Stoic teachings. To know that we know nothing and that we consistently have to educate ourselves and move ourselves from where we are to a position of more understanding and more empathy towards one another. Number two, justice. And I'll admit I don't have a very strong grasp of the Stoic view of justice, but I will attempt to explain the Stoic view of justice to the best of my abilities. The Stoics see justice through a form of kindness and compassion. An ability to seek fairness. You see, the Stoics know that within all people is the propensity to commit evil. And you may look at another individual who has committed a heinous crime and say, oh, this is a terrible person. But in reality, this is just another human being who is in a situation that caused evil. And that if it were you in that situation, with their genetics and their biology and their learning through the environment that they grew up in, then you would realize that you would have done the exact same thing. And it is for this reason that we can find compassion and seek less retribution for the things committed in order to reach back to a state of equilibrium and fairness and justice. Alrighty. Number three, courage. If any man can make you do something that you do not want to do, it is because you do not know how to die. A quote from the author. Courage doesn't mean that you're not afraid of any given situation. Courage means that even though you're afraid, you do what is right. Whatever you believe to be morally right, you continue to do it despite the fear. A quote that I think would go very well with this concept of courage. Cowards die many times before their deaths. The valiant taste of death but once. And basically, what this means is to live in constant fear and constant anxiety is to die many, many times. It's to experience the suffering and the pain of death many, many times. But the brave who conquer fear and who can do anything because they have conquered fear, because they no longer fear death, can pretty much do anything within reason. To quote the Pirates of the Caribbean, the debt that all men pay is death. And we have no control over that. Everyone dies because we know that we all die. This is something that we should not be afraid of. We have no control over the fact that we all die one day, so why worry about it? Number four, moderation. Moderation is hugely important. Moderation can refer to the idea of modern day minimalism. People often think they need more and more and more of a given thing to feel more enjoyment from it. But it is actually rather the opposite. To have enough of something is to enjoy it for the most value that something can bring. It is difficult to obtain more and more and more. To obtain the basic necessities is much simpler and much easier, and to support that form of living for a much longer period of time. Moderation and minimalism being buying only the basic necessities for survival and spending money more on the things that bring you the most value and joy rather than simply just consuming everything in sight and buying as much as you possibly can with the money you have, moving on from the virtues of Stoicism and continuing on to some of the topics that I found the most important. And I want to say that this was really difficult for me, just trying to synthesize all the information that I found valuable into 10 main topics. There are so many valuable ways of thinking, so much valuable information that's held within Stoicism and within this book, that I would highly encourage anyone to go out and read from this philosophy or read this book and not just take it for my opinion and my words. Anyway, number 5, focus on what you can control and forget about what you can't control. And this idea is very well explained in the book Man's Search for Meaning by Viktor Frankl. Is this idea that no matter what happens to us, no matter how horrible the situation, the thing that cannot be taken away from us is the ability to choose how you react to any given situation. The ability to paint your own picture on the situation and choose how you react. And that's really the only thing we can control, is how we choose to react to any given situation. And for those things that depress us, those things that cause us anxiety, whether that be holding on to the past, something that is already non-existent anymore. It's dead. It's in the past. You can't change it. So why worry about it? Or something that's happening in the future. You have no control over it. Whatever is going to happen is just going to happen. You do the best you can and then you don't worry about it. Because worrying about it, stressing out about it, something that hasn't even happened yet, doesn't do you any good. It just takes up mental effort. Number 6, mortality and change. So like I said, we all die one day, and everything changes year to year, day to day, second to second. Nothing stays the same. We're all in a constant building up of things and a constant decay of things. And it's this acceptance of mortality and change that allows us to be more present in the world, to be more fully engaged in whatever we're doing or whoever we're spending time with, because we know that this moment is truly all we get. And that's it. And when that moment is done, you are never guaranteed that moment again. So it places much more value on the things that we do and we interact with. It places more value on our time because it is ephemeral. It's lasting for only a short time. Number 7, desire and detachment. Like I've said in previous videos, desire causes suffering. The more you desire and the more you are unable to reach those desires in a consistent and healthy manner, the more you will suffer mentally, physically. The quickest way to be twice as happy is literally to want half as much. And it comes with this idea of detachment, of whatever things that we desire the most, of whatever we hold on to the firmest that brings us the most joy. It's these things, if lost, that will cause us the most pain. And to put a space in between you and those things, to have a certain level of detachment allows you to be much more present in the world, and at the same time gives you a much more objective view of things, allowing you to view your own experiences as less biased and more objective, which allows you to make better decisions. Number 8, lifestyle inflation. So lifestyle inflation goes back to this idea of desire causing suffering. If you come into more money or you start making more money, you say, hey, you know, I deserve more stuff. So you start buying more, you upgrade to a bigger apartment, you buy more furniture, you start buying better food. And before you know it, all that money that you had is gone again. And you have to go out and you have to work more hours to support this higher lifestyle. So when you start to make more money, you really have to be careful about lifestyle inflation. If you are attempting to save money in order to invest it, to build a lifetime income for yourself, then you have to be very wary of lifestyle inflation. You have to continue investing, saving, putting aside money, and attempt to keep your lifestyle the way it is, at its most base nature, and the idea of minimalism. Buying only what you need and only what brings you the most value and the most happiness in life. Number 9, true wealth is when you find out you have enough. You can be a billionaire, or you can be broke. But if you know in your heart that you have enough, then you're wealthy. If all your basic necessities are met and you don't need more, then you are a wealthy individual. Wealth is a state of mind. It's not a certain amount of money. And yes, it's nicer to have money than to not have money. But remember, You can be rich and miserable. So money is not the goal. The goal is to have enough. And finally, number 10, a quote from the book. Be deaf to those who love you most of all. They pray for bad things with good intentions. There is only one good, the cause and the support of a happy life. Trust in oneself. Montaigne, 1980. And this idea basically says, be very careful with who you take advice from. Just because someone loves you doesn't mean they know what is best for you. You have to be able to listen to yourself and trust in your own opinions. You have to be able to go out and find other people who are aligned with the same things that you believe and be able to trust yourself and trust your opinions. Forgive yourself for making mistakes and live your life to the best of your abilities. Bonus number 11. The last occupation of the occupied man is living. Basically what this means is people are so busy. They're so busy all the time doing this or doing that or whatever that they don't even take the time to live, to enjoy life for what it is, or to do the things that are actually the most important to them. And it's not until they fall sick or they have a brush with mortality that they really realize what is most important to them and how limited their time really is. And it takes a lifetime to learn how to live and how to die. Anyway, this is not financial, medical, or aloha spirit advice. Please remember to dislike and unsub from the channel. I am not a professional. Please talk to a professional before taking any of the information that I say into action. This information is purely for entertainment purposes. Thank you very much for watching, and cue the outro. Oh gosh, I did it on the wrong side.